Bob Tasca and his team finished off last year winning the finals at Pomona. They wound up third in the funny car point standings, but they can't help but imagine what if. After all, they led the points for 8 of the first 9 races.
The long and short of the story is we ran out of some parts on the car, and we had to switch a different manufacturer with some different parts, and that kind of threw us a curveball for a little while to get our tune-up correctly for, you know, those parts that we had to switch to.
To keep that from happening this year, instead of ordering parts 4 races out, they've now made sure they have the parts they need for at least the next 10 races. Getting those parts ready has been a focus of the offseason, but the most important thing they've been working on is...
The biggest thing for us was we had some personnel changes here, so we had to go and hire a couple new guys and get them acclimated with where all the stuff is here in the trailers and where all the tools are, and get them trained in their departments. So that's the biggest thing we've been working with this offseason, really, which is not that big of a deal, but it's just a change from last year.
How the new crew works together during the turnarounds will be a focus of the upcoming test at Phoenix, as will improving the car's performance.
The goal is obviously to keep being consistent, or try to be more consistent. And we lost a couple races. We lost a lot, actually, rounds and races last year by a few thousandths of a second. So just trying to get a little bit better ET with this thing, and maybe a little bit more aggressive, you know, earlier in the runs if we can, the 60-foot in the 330, and then the split from the 60-foot to the 330 is what we probably will be working on to try to, like I said, improve on our ETs from last year.
In just a few days, they'll load up the trucks and head west for the start of the season. For the NHRA, I'm John Kernan in Indianapolis.